I'm leaving the garage slightly open right now to give me some airflow. Does anyone know what it's like to live in a place where it's 100 degrees every single day for the entire month of July and like August? And so far, it's brutally hot here in Sacramento area. Okay, we are back, or I'm back. It's been so long since I've done one of these videos, and it's just been an incredibly busy summer, and I've also been dealing with some health issues with myself and my family, but I'm okay now for the most part. I still just have a little bit of some lingering coughs here and there, but I'm okay. But yeah, as you guys can see, the knife wall behind me is pretty much like, I don't know, more than halfway empty. And that's because all the knives are here, plus another box of knives that I've just pulled out. And the reason I've been pulling them off the wall is because I'm making space for some new knives. My original intention was basically to clear the wall off and only have like 7 or 12 knives to keep as a reference, but I recently went to Japan about a month ago and I went on a shopping spree. So let's put these away, grab the other boxes, and we'll go from there. My center, here we go. You know, I'm gonna push these to the side. Okay, let's see what we got here. Ah! this one, okay, so I told you guys that Doi-san actually gifted me with two knives. One petty that he made that morning on my way into the factory, and then another one that he made, I think, earlier the day. But let me show you what they are. This is a petty that is, it's a raw blank. It doesn't have any sharp angles on it at all. So yeah, he knows that I love restoring knives, and so he actually made this for me, hoping that I will make a video of it and of me, you know, basically making a raw blank into a knife. And so this is it. But yeah, so I'm super excited for this knife. I will put it together at some point, and I'll make a separate video just for this petty right here. Look at this. Look at this one. This is beautiful. And so yeah, this has not been sharpened. It does have a bevel in it, or the shinogi line. Other than that though, I mean, it's got rust all over it. So I'll bring this to life at some point. I'll do it soon. I think this one I really want to do as quickly as possible. But I cannot wait to get this into cutting form. Ah, a knife by Ryusen. Ah, so this is a nakiri that I got. Ah, so a lot of you guys have been asking me for rubber cutting board reviews and plastic cutting board reviews. This is a brand called Hasegawa. I bought a small one here for review. I also bought a cleaner for it. And then in the kitchen right now, I actually have a board made by, who is it made by? Anyways, I have another rubberized cutting board that I'm already testing right now. So I'll post a review for that board and compare it with this board very soon. Ah, okay, this. Yes, okay. So this knife here I got from Saji-san when I went to visit Ichizen. And it's a folding steak knife. And so I don't use steak knives very often, and but this is just a very beautiful piece and a beautiful example from a master who may not be making knives that much longer. So to me, this is a very special piece that I'll have for a long time. So this is a bracelet. Wow, look at this. Beautiful, beautiful piece. So the backstory is, this is actually made by Nakayama Hidetoshi. So Hidetoshi is a very famous jewelry designer in Japan. And so this was gifted to me by Professor X. He knows I love bracelets. I don't know much about this artist, but I hear that he makes a lot of stuff that the Yakuza wears. So, you know, I don't know, if I put this on, it'd be like a Yakuza symbol or some sort. And this bracelet is on its last legs. There's actually, it's literally just hanging by a single thread on one of the clasps right now. So my kids are always pulling on my bracelet, and one time it almost fell off. So I've already talked to my wife about trying to figure out how to make this stronger when it does break, and So yeah, we're kind of just waiting for this thing to break, and we'll figure this out. But this bracelet will never leave my side. But Professor X, thank you for this bracelet. It's beautiful. It's very nice. I just hope that I don't become a a face of the Yakuza at some point. Ah, look at this. Ah, this is beautiful. This is a Tanaka, and it's a 270mm. I think it's 270. Very beautiful knife. Ah, this is another knife from Tanaka-san. And this one here, I believe, is a white number 2. It's a 210 gyuto. Very beautiful. Very nice knife. So I'm very excited for this knife right here. You guys just gotta hear this. You have to hear this knife. Woo! You hear that? Oh my goodness, that is beautiful. Excuse me. Two knives from you, Kurosaki-san. So, oh. Oh my goodness, that is beautiful. This is a 240 using R2 or SG2. And it's got that signature that he does with his, all of his knives. His knives are just so well done and so artistic and really bold. But man, so clean. So clean. I love this thing. Ah. Oh, I can't wait to use it in the kitchen. Oh. Okay. Oh. That is beautiful. So beautiful. Oh my goodness. Look at this handle. It feels perfect in my hands. I cannot wait to use this. This is... it's a work of art. Supreme. This is Zanmai, I believe. But I had two of their knives here, and they're both very well put together. This one here has caught my attention because I believe it has the solid VG10 like steel as a blade. Yes. Oh. Yes, it's a solid VG10. It's a coreless steel. And also, it's got this really intricate, twisted, octagonal handle, which I have always been a fan of. And so when I saw this knife in the shop, I bought one, and it's just very well put together. The spine, very nicely polished. I'm very excited to use a VG10 coreless steel in the kitchen. I've never had a VG10 coreless, with the exception of the Shun Pro Yanagiba, which is a coreless knife, but it's a yanagiba. You don't get to use it very often. This is the very first VG10 gyuto that I'll have in my kitchen. And it is exquisitely done, very beautifully crafted handle, the ferrule, stainless steel ferrule, and just a very nice, nice put together knife. So I'm excited for this knife. So I believe this is from Saji. There we go. Ah, this is from Saji-san, and it's an R2 core steel with the custom ironwood handle that he is very well known for, very sculpted, and has a very much a custom feel in your hands. And this is using the oxide finishing that he does, and that a number of people are using, but he does it very well. And Saji-san is, his background is he makes hunting knives, and so his knives are very rustic, and just has a very unique feel to them. This knife is beautiful, and I cannot wait to use this. It's got a great polish on the spine, on the choil. Yeah, and the handle is just exquisitely done. Very comfortable. Has a nice girthy feel to it. It's not light, but this knife here is just a very hunter feel to it. It's got a great, great grip in the handle department, and just a very beautifully crafted, from a master. So, this is great. This is a knife from Sakai Takayuki. It's a dagger. I don't know what I'll use it for. I mean, I can probably use it. I don't know what I'll use it for, but it's beautiful. It's a memento from the folks at Sakai Takayuki for the very exciting partnership that we've got going on. Yeah. I love it. I mean, you know, it's maybe I have an addiction. You know, even though I know I'm not going to use a knife or a piece of cutlery the way it's intended or ever, I just get so excited to look at a handcrafted piece of steel like this. Maybe it's just me. Okay, so we've got two more knives that I just want to show you really quickly here. The Burrfection knife. This is a final production sample of the knife. And yeah, they just want to show me what their final finishes, the finishing touches of this knife is going to be. This is it here. It is done. Okay. So let's go to the next knife. Ta-da! So, a lot of you guys have been asking me, you know, to design a knife that is larger. Yeah, so we're looking at 55 millimeters right here. And yeah, so a lot of folks have been asking for a taller, larger knife that has this, you know, wonderful sabatier profile. And this is it. This is more or less the first production sample of that knife. I've kind of held off. I wasn't exactly sure if this is a knife that I should make. But so I drew out some sizing samples and I sent them over to the folks over at Sakai Takayuki. And this is what they've got for me. So, you know, it's not on pre-order yet. I'm still gonna tweak a couple things. I'll make a couple minor adjustments of the specs after I use it in my home for a couple of weeks. Making a knife is very time consuming because I get a sample here, I use it, I make some suggestions to some specs tweaking, and then they make that sample and then send it back here. And so before you guys actually even hear about a knife, it's gone through maybe 3 or 4 months of revisions. Yeah, so that is it. For this box, I'm not going to open up all the other boxes because there are so many things to go through. And let me just put this away really quickly. And I want to spend a lot of my time reviewing, at least on my channel, handmade knives, because I really believe that they deserve more attention. And I love them because they're handmade knives. They're not going to be made forever. And I think handmade knives are going to go away, or at least in terms of affordability, over the next 10, 15 years. We're going to see knives, you know, that are factory made, that are machine made, really take over the market. So to me, this is like a dying breed, a dying art that I want to preserve as long as I can. And so that's why I'm focusing a lot more of my efforts into reviewing handmade knives. And so I invested a lot of money buying these knives here. But yeah, you know, this is kind of a new chapter on Burrfection. We're going to change up a lot of things. And I really just want to invest more time working with artisans and collaborating with artisans, which you guys will hear a lot more about in the coming months. The wall looks a little lonely, so let's do something about it. The first knife up, Tanaka-san's knife. The Burrfection knife. I'm gonna make a row of just Burrfection design knives right down here. Ah, this is the other Tanaka knife. Ah, that's beautiful. So beautiful. That knife looks awfully small next to the 270 over there. We'll put up the Zanmai because it's beautiful. From Saji-san, the Yu Kurosaki. This is going up. The other Yu Kurosaki has to go up as well. Ah, yes. And of course, this deserves to go up on the wall, doesn't it? It needs a space. The Petty? Why not? Let's put this up as well. It deserves a space, huh? You know, my knife wall is coming back to life. You know, I'm excited for it. And for those who are curious, all the knives that I pulled off the wall are going into a pile. Basically, I'm gonna sell to my Patreon supporters and whatever is remaining will go to the public. So if you guys wanna see what knives I got for sale and whetstones, I'm basically getting rid of everything that you guys are no longer seeing on the wall and 90% of my whetstone collection because I'm starting a really big project and I simply need the space. In my garage. Yeah, so check the video description for the link and yeah, have fun, okay? All right guys, thank you for being here and I'll catch you in the next video.